of two churches and that you were both able to take part. I just wondered actually, have you ever thought about doing a comic duo? I'm sure you get on very well. Well, they do get to dress up funny as well. Not that I dress up funny. Also, a big thank you to the churches as well, maybe Thomas and Tom can pass it on, because I know both St Mark's and the church here have actually done an awful lot in preparation for today, and it's been really good, their contribution. It's been a joy to be a part of those churches, and we both felt part of both churches, and it's been really good today to actually have everyone taking part. So please pass on our thanks. Our thanks to the little ones, in particular, to Stuart and to Darren for the part they played, and to my brother as well for being usher, for throwing you into the church and making sure you sat on the right side. A big thank you. I think one of my biggest thanks has got to be to Fraser. Fraser and I have been around a long time together, as you may have gathered. We do get on quite well together. I thought he'd promised that he was going to have no dirty jokes. I have no idea what Irish Presbyterian ministers are like. Dirty jokes. If you've got a spare moment later on, he's actually got a really good joke that he told me, but it's not fit for telling you. I dare you to go up to him and mention the numbers. I'm sure you must have one to 100 or something. So, yeah, thank you. Lastly, can I thank you all for coming? It's been a joy again for Linda and myself to actually have so many friends here. To actually be part of a day that's been a long time coming, yes. And as we say, we really hope that you've enjoyed it. Thank you for the presents. We're going to have the extension built in a few months' time, so we can get going. Oh, the presents.
Just the presents.
Once Dad lets me have the shed, we'll have somewhere to sleep. So again, thank you very much. Thank you to the bridesmaids. You did a good job and you were very well behaved. I began to wonder if it was the same family. No, sorry.
Very well.
Big ones and little ones. So you'd be glad I'm going to shut up now. Would you please stand as I propose a toast to the bridesmaids?
If he could borrow a penny from him to go and phone one of his friends. Winston Churchill looked at him and turned to him and gave him tuppence and says, "Here, phone them all." George and Linda, it's been really good to share in your name, and I'm sure tuppence wouldn't be enough to pay for all the phone calls to your friends. And some of your friends here, we are truly delighted to be invited. That's been poetic, isn't it? And it's been good for us to share with you. On behalf of the bridesmaids and all of us who took part, it was indeed our privilege.
Mama.
Been a lot said about the different denominations that have taken part in the services today. I'd just like to tell a story about Church of England man, a Roman Catholic man, and a Presbyterian man. And they used to meet once a month, and they would discuss all sorts of issues of the day. So this month they decided to meet, and they thought that confession would be good for the soul. And so they decided they would tell all of their problems to one another. So the Church of England man started the ball rolling. He says, I get on fine until it comes to the drink. He says, I'm fond of the drink, and I'm tempted just to take a wee bit too much and to go over the top. So they all sort of looked and just kept their heads bowed and didn't make any comment. And it came to the priest and he sort of stammers a wee bit and he says, well, he says, you know, he says, my problem is with a woman. He says, I quite like to get away out of this place and take off my collar and go chasing women. They're all sort of looking at one another over here. And then there's the Presbyterian's come. And he sort of says, no, he says, I'm not telling you. No way am I telling you what my greatest problem is, what my greatest sin is. They all coaxed him and says, oh no, you'll have to tell us. After all, we've shared all our problems and all our sins with you. So he says, well, if you really must know. He says, I find that my biggest problem is that I've got a gossip. And so with that in mind, as a true Presbyterian, possibly a bit of a gossip, I can start on George. I thought, how do you start to describe George? And I racked my brain for a wee while. Maybe the best way to do it was to use his initials. George Donald Watts. So I took G, D and W. I started with the G. I thought, George, the best way to describe is gracious. When we were at university, George proved to be a real good friend. Someone that you could trust and go to. Someone that was kind and well thought of throughout the whole university campus. And I think to describe him as gracious would be fair. Then I thought about what could I call the D. And it had to be dedicated. Because George is dedicated to God and to Jesus Christ as the most important thing in his life. And it was through that dedication that we met, Matthew, see you. And I'm sure that as you continue in your married life, you will remain dedicated to your calling through Jesus Christ. And then it came to the W. I thought, what could the W stand for? So my wife, who doesn't know George very well, suggested it could stand for wonderful. Nah. That would be a bit OTT. Then we thought, wise. Nah. We decided against wise. We thought, what about wicked? Well, we're going to stick with that if we started to tell jokes. So we decided, no, not wicked. By this time, we were starting to run out of W's. So what we came up with is that George is weirdly on time. Surprised today when George told me that he'd be around at the house between 10 and 11 when George turns up at 20 to 10. Which must say something of his keenness to get in and get married. What about Linda? Well, what about her? I don't know you that well, Linda. I thought about finding out all the scene details. I thought that's not really fair. It's meant to be her day, but meant to be nice. But I decided that they would be nice to. And so we started off with L, and we thought that you looked lovely. And you didn't indeed, you looked really well. In fact, as we stood in the church, George was commanded by his mother to face the front and the and he's standing there looking straight ahead like a good wee boy. First thing he's probably done when he's told in years. He says to me, he says, you look, I'm not from you. What's she wearing? So I thought that. I turned around and looked. She's wearing green, John. I'm sure he looked around quickly just to check. So we started off with Linda Luke, lovely. And then the J stands for joy. And we thought, well, we just leave it like that. Because in seeing George's face when he's seen you, you brought a lot of joy to his life. And I know that from the few times that we have met, that the joy comes too from that personal faith in Jesus Christ. And we do trust you'll carry on in the calling that he has brought to you both as a couple together. Then we came to the S, and we got stunning. Well, really, if it said lovely, it would have meant stunning as well. Then we thought successful. Well, yeah, that would be true. You'd be successful in her work and everything she's done so far. Then she got George. So we bumped for stupid. We've known one another for 2.5 years. Well, because it was only 18 months ago that I came to Gillingham for the first time for a long time. And there was George, and he started to speak about this Linda. I think Brad's smile on his face. Now, I'm always the last to know about things and about who's going out for who, and I always put that and get it all wrong. You know, this Linda, I thought, I've got it right this time. Because George would say things to me, you know, says, you know, it's really pointless, us. I mean, we have 2 cars, we have 2 houses, they have 2 of everything. I really enjoyed saying, this is the reason pointless is having 2 of everything. And I wish I said it to him, he was really getting at, you know, we'd as well be married and sharing things together. And I'm not really quite good at picking up these hints and things, but on that day, 18 months ago, I looked at my wife and says, you know, George has found a woman. And I'm sure that this is the woman George is going to settle with. And for the first time in my life, I'll be fine. I remember it clearly because we played Trivial Pursuits that night. And it wasn't so much Trivial Pursuits, it was more a female pursuit as the pair of you gazed in one another's eyes. And I successfully won. You know, George has changed a lot since we first met in university days. You know, he's like a country lad come to town. And boy, the wee country lad has finally been hooked. The president of our SOS club, which for those of you who don't realise is the Save Our Singles, has finally been caught. He's gone all modern, hasn't he? Complete with designer stubble and filer bags. Wedding must be getting a job, I'm going all grey. Then she turned to me, she says, you know, she says, you're really not with it, are you? These are hints. There you go. It's been great to be here. It's been great to share with your day. Let me just finish by assuring you of my prayers and support. And may the Lord bless you and keep you. May make his panic face to shine upon you. It falls on me now to begin to read the cards and telegrams. I hope you'll bear with me. I'll not read the verses, I'll just read the names as we go through. There's 3 telegrams came. There's to Linda and George. They've got it wrong, it should be George and Linda.